Welcome to this video baccalaureate service in honor of the Daniel Boone High School graduating class of 2020, Visions of Hope. I have been a part of many baccalaureate services at Daniel Boone High School, but never one quite like this. I've always been impressed by the creativity and character of seniors as they prepare for graduation. This year, our seniors have faced an absolutely unique and challenging situation. And we could not blame them if they fell into lethargy or despair, but they have not. I have to admit, I've often harbored a fair amount of concern about the effect of social media on our young people, and I still have some concerns, but who knew? Who knew what a powerful means of connection and encouragement these technologies would be in a time like this? God provides us with the resources and the strength that we depend on to persevere in circumstances such as these. We wish things would have been different for the class of 2020, but ultimately such wishes avail us nothing. Instead, perhaps this trial will be a source of strength for a generation that we very much need. This class was born around the time of 9/11, and they are graduating in the time of coronavirus. And they just might be the generation that through adversity has acquired the moral courage and stamina necessary to bring healing in the midst of brokenness in our society. We pray now that God will give them that strength, that courage, that faith, and a powerful vision of hope as they move into their future.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains should shake in the heart of the sea.
Though the waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult.
There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High.
God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns.
The nations are in an uproar. The kingdom totters. He utters his voice, the earth melts.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth.
He makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire.
Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth.
Lord of hosts is with us, and the God of Jacob is our refuge.
Let us enter into a spirit of prayer. Loving God, in your goodness, you have brought us to this special time of praise and celebration. We pray that you remain with the class of 2020 in their daily lives and keep them faithful to you. Guide these graduates in whatever path they pursue, and give them the strength to trust in you, so that they may be guided by the vision of hope shown forth in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
This scripture reading is from Isaiah 40, verses 28 through 31. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer.
Hebrews 12:1 and 2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin that clings to us so closely, and let us run with perseverance the race that he has set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and protector of our faith, who for the sake of the joy that was set before him endured the cross. Disregarding its shame, he has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God.
What I want my class to be most remembered for. Well, there's a lot of different situations that happened this year with the pandemic and so many different challenges that we had to face together. It's really just our class, I wanted her to be remembered for perseverance, the ability to go online, do all the things that we were able to do to be able to graduate while still being under the situations that we were this year.
I hope our class will be remembered not as the class that lost their senior year, but instead as the one that came out the other side stronger than before.
I'm really proud of our class in general for overcoming a lot of challenges. I feel like our class has moved forward a lot with obstacles in their way. But most importantly, I would like our class to be remembered as the class that scared Mr. Simmons into retirement. See, Mr. Simmons for me was one of my favorite statistics professors and one of my favorite teachers in general. He was an awesome guy, and I just think it's great that he did not want to teach our class.
I am grateful for the friendships and memories I made at Boone.
The thing I'm most grateful for through my high school career is my great AP physics teacher, Mr. Helzer. Mr. Helzer is not just a teacher who can teach AP physics very well, but he's also a teacher that can make you enjoy AP physics through his jokes and other stuff while also being a great teacher. Mr. Helzer allowed me to get a 3 on my AP exam and also enjoy AP physics to a level I don't think I could ever imagine.
What I'm actually most grateful for from my high school experience is that I did experience adversities, and each year was a different lesson learned that I will continue to carry throughout my entire life.
I think the class of 2020 is very special in the sense that we don't let anything get in our way. You know, this whole global pandemic we got going on is quite the predicament, and we found creative ways to keep our lives somewhat normal in this situation, such as videos for these. And I've just been amazed by all the creativity I've seen over different things like birthday parades and stuff like that. So I'm so proud of how we've all come together in something like this and we're able to make something good out of it.
Though our current situation with the pandemic has not been ideal, for me, there has been some positives that have come out of it. I have had the opportunity to spend more time with my family right before I go to college. It has brought people together all while staying apart. Everyone seems to be taking a step back and slowing down. People thinking about and helping others seems to be in the news more than ever before. Our environment has even been improving because of us staying at home. Maybe there was a master plan all along.
Some good things that I've been able to come out of this pandemic is that I've been able to spend more time with family and develop some more good habits and just have more free time in general, which is always great, but it's especially good during this time before I go off to college. And while many bad things are going on in the world, it's just helpful to find some silver linings that can provide hope. And it's also helpful for me to realize that this is all part of God's plan in some way.
There are times in my day when I'm so tired that I lack the energy to reach for the remote, and yet there's someone who is living above me who would literally go and has gone to hell and back so that I could be saved and live with him in eternal paradise. So, of all the questions that I asked myself in high school, the greatest one has been, what could I possibly do to repay him? And how can I live my life to be more like him? Because it's those two questions that get me through all the other questions I have out there.
There are so many things that you can take away from a time like this, but some of the most important things that I've learned through this quarantine is to not take things for granted. There are a lot of little things that we just kind of accept because they're there all the time. And now that they've been taken away, you kind of realize that you become really thankful for those things. And that's something that I'll carry on with me for the rest of my life. And I will definitely cherish the time that I have with my family and my friends and the things that we do. Something else that I learned is just to enjoy the little things. While you're home in quarantine, you just kind of take all the little victories that you can get in your house with your family, and you look at the positives that you're enjoying the time with your family and the things that you do, and just trying to make the best out of a terrible situation. And the final thing that I learned is just to hold on to hope that things will get better. I mean, there were a lot of times, especially for the class of 2020, where it seemed pretty bleak for the rest of our academic careers in high school, and we've just held on to hope that things will get better for the future and that we'll become better people because of it. And the resiliency that we're showing and the community coming around and supporting us has showed us all that we just have to hold on to hope that things will get better.
Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul
and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all.
And the sweetest in the gale is heard.
And sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird
that kept so many warm. I've heard it in the chillest land.
And on the strangest sea.
Yet never in extremity, it asked a crumb of me.
God sent his son. Called him Jesus, he came to land, he went for gift, he lived and died, to buy my pardon, an empty grave is there to prove my Savior.
Lord, you have sent your Holy Spirit into the world to guide and protect your children. We ask you now to send that Holy Spirit to all of our graduates, to guide and protect them in all of their callings, that they may know your presence and know your love and glorify you in all that they do. Lord, watch over and protect us.
Embrace these young women and men and their families in this time of change and uncertainty and adventure. Let them always be aware that you are doing more than they can imagine or even ask for. Surround them with the love that casts out fear and doubt and leads to a hope for a bright future.
God of wonder and power, watch over these graduates as they journey forward. Protect them through hardships. Strengthen them through dark times. Guide them through moments of uncertainty by your loving presence. Lord, watch over and guide us.
Let us join together now and lift our voices to the Lord, asking for encouragement and hope in the midst of the difficulties that the class of 2020 has faced.
In the midst of this time of pandemic and quarantine and of uncertainty, Lord, we pray for joy that cannot be taken away as we join our hearts with all the graduates in celebrating their years of work and accomplishment. Lord, watch over us and guide us.
For God's blessing upon our graduates as they face the challenges and opportunities of the years ahead, may they seek to serve others first, especially the poor and those most vulnerable in our midst. And in doing so, establish a more just and peaceful world, we pray. Lord, watch over us and guide us. Lord, hear and answer the prayers we have offered for the graduates of Daniel Boone High School, the class of 2020. We acknowledge these young men and women to be your sons and daughters, precious in your sight, and destined for glory. Together with their parents, family, teachers, and friends, we thank you for bringing us to this day of rejoicing. Empower our graduates with the gifts of your Holy Spirit. Give them wisdom, make them courageous, help them to exercise right judgment, and fill their hearts with your love. Loving Lord, bless them from this day forward. Guide these young men and women to do what is right, to love goodness, and to walk humbly with you, their God, every day of their lives. We ask all these things, invoking your most holy name, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust,
and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand.
The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wing your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield,
and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the
the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by the day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not fall.
And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun.
His hand.